Okay. So our rule is not to avoid a place where there's drinking if we have a legitimate reason for being there. Now notice that when you get to the 11th and 12th steps, you get to take a PhD in recovery, which means that now motive becomes extremely important.
Yeah.
And whereas before the big book wasn't concentrating on motive, apparently they didn't overload their circuits that much when they were working the steps. But by the time we get to the 11th step and the 12th step, motive becomes real important. And the reason for that's simple. We can do the right thing for the wrong motive, and it's just as damaging and dangerous for us to do the wrong thing.
Amen.
Okay, so now we're going to have to be not only aware of our actions, and of the defects which are creeping in, but we're going to have to also be aware of our motives for doing what we're doing. And if we think back on our drinking, drugging careers, we realize that we had some really terrible motives for the things that we did. I mean, motive was something which drove us to do things which were clearly against our scruples, against our sense of right and wrong, against our sense of morality and our sense of ethics. So what we're learning here is that we can even go to plain ordinary whoopee parties. Now that's not a party which has these funny cushions when you sit on them they make a noise. A whoopee party in the 1930s was with flappers and bathtub gin and everybody putting a lampshade on their head and doing the Charleston. That was a whoopee party. Now, I like the idea of whoopee parties, actually. In fact, when I ask people if there are any announcements, commercial announcements for AA, I always ask them if you want to announce a bingo party or a whoopee party or bowling alley, you know, whatever, fishing. Okay. You will note that we've made an important qualification, page 101. Therefore, ask yourself on each occasion, have I any good social, business, or personal reason for going to this place, or am I expecting to steal a little vicarious pleasure from the atmosphere of such places? And so this is really telling us that we can delude ourselves into thinking, oh, I can go down to my local bar hangout where they've been keeping the stool warm for me, and I can sit down and have a soda, and everybody will come over and tell me how wonderfully I'm doing and how glad they are to see me, and they really miss me. Well, there are a bunch of drunks in there, and the miss is maybe for 30 seconds,
yeah,
30 minutes at the outside. These are people, as we were, totally centered on themselves. But it's our own imagination that we need to go back and make sure that they understand we still love them, because after all, we spent a good part of our lives in there and most of our fortune.